All right, so we're now in a great position to talk about what the network part of the neural network is about. So now the idea is that we can construct, using exactly these kinds of sigmoid units, a chain of relationships between the input layer, which are the different components of X, with the output, Y. And the way this is going to happen is there's other layers of units in between, that each one is computing the weighted sum, sigmoided, of the layer before it. These other layers of units are often referred to as hidden layers because you can kind of see the inputs and you can see the outputs, that this other stuff is less constrained or indirectly constrained. And what's happening is that each of these units, it's running exactly that kind of, take the weights, multiply by the things coming into it, put it through the sigmoid, and that's your activation, that's your output. So what's cool about this is in the case where all these are sigmoid units, this mapping from input to output is differentiable in terms of the weights. And by saying the whole thing is differentiable, what I'm saying is that we can figure out for any given weight in the network how moving it up or down a little bit is going to change the mapping from inputs to outputs. So we can move all those weights in the direction of producing something more like the output that we want, even though there's all these sort of crazy nonlinearities in between. And so this leads to an idea called backpropagation, which is really just at its heart a computationally beneficial organization of the chain rule. We're just computing the derivatives with respect to all the different weights in the network, all in one convenient way that has this lovely interpretation of having information flowing from the inputs to the outputs and then error information flowing back from the outputs towards the inputs. And that tells you how to compute all the derivatives and then therefore how to make all the weight updates to make the network produce something more like what you wanted it to produce. So this is where learning is actually taking place. And it's really neat. This backpropagation is referring to the fact that the errors are flowing backward. Sometimes it's even called error backpropagation.
Nice. So here's a question for you, Michael. What happens if I replace the sigmoid units with some other function? And let's say that function is also differentiable.
Well, if it's differentiable, then we can still do this basic kind of trick that says we can compute derivatives and therefore we can move weights around to try to get the network to produce what we want it to produce.
That's a big win. Does it still act like a perceptron?
Well, even this doesn't act exactly like a perceptron, right? So it's really just analogous to a perceptron because we're not really doing the hard thresholding. We don't have guarantees of convergence in finite time. In fact, the error function can have many local optima. And what we mean by that is this idea that we're trying to set the weight so that the error is low, but you can get to these situations where none of the weights can really change without making the error worse. And you'd like to think, well, good, then we're done. We've made the error as low as we can make it. But in fact, it could actually just be stuck in a local optimum, that there's a much better way of setting the weights. It's just we have to change more than just one weight at a time to get there.
Oh, so that makes sense. So if we think about the sigmoid and the error function that we picked, right? The error function was sum of squared errors. So that looks like a parabola in some high dimensional space. But once we start combining them with others like this over and over and over again, then we have an error space where there might be lots of places that look low, but only look low if you're standing there, but globally would not be the lowest point.
Right, exactly right. And so you can get these situations in just the one unit version where the error function, as you said, is this nice little parabola and you can move down the gradient and when you get down to the bottom, you're done. But now when we start throwing these networks of units together, we can get an error surface that just in its cartoon form looks crazy like this, that it's smooth, but there's these places where it goes down, it comes up again, goes down maybe further, comes up again, doesn't come down as far. And you could easily get yourself stuck at a point like this where you're not at the global minimum, you're at some local optimum.